So what's going on, man?
Just training hard, and I'm going to be fighting again really soon. Another amateur fight before I turn pro and maybe fight for PBC. I don't know.
You're a fan favorite out here, man.
Yeah, I mean, I go to all the boxing fights, Orange County, L.A., Vegas, so sometimes Texas, so I take pictures, a lot of people ask pictures with the fans, so I don't know. I'm repping this new shirt. Everyone loves it, so yeah.
I've seen some of your videos that you lost some weight, man, since you've been off steroids.
Hey. They're not gonna keep me off the meat. Me gusta la carne asada, mucho especial. So, yeah. I hope it's 8 rounds or less. I don't know. He might pay a price for being off the juice. That's what Bob said. So, I don't know. Work, make money, work, come to fights, have fun, just enjoy life. Whatever comes up, you know. I don't have plans. You can't ask me what I'm going to do next week because I don't know what I'm going to do. So, but just my plan is to have fun. That's it.
How many pitches do you take a year?
They say it everywhere. I don't even like pay attention really anymore. I just take a picture. If they're respectful, yeah, I'll take a picture with them. I guess maybe that's the reason why, you know, Oscar kicked me out of a bunch of boxing fights is because, you know, it's like I'm taking pictures with a whole bunch of people. Let me give you an example. I was inside the MGM, and I was taking pictures with a bunch of people right after the weigh-in with Chavez Jr. and Canelo. Everyone's asking me for pictures. Next thing you know, Oscar calls the security. I'm surrounded by like 15 police officers, and you know, they're telling me that I have to leave. I'm not Canelo. And they came up to me and they're like, Larry, I need to see your ID. I was like, okay, well, why am I being kicked out? And the only thing they do is they just keep repeating themselves. Like, you're not Canelo, you're not Canelo, you're not. That's all they can say. That's all their defense is wear a hat or, it's like, dude, everyone's screaming. What am I supposed to do? Tell everyone I'm not him? Like, you know, it's just, they did it to me. Oscar did it to me at the StubHub, Vegas. I mean, tons of times, never a refund. He's disrespectful. I mean, last time I talked to him, he's pointing his finger at my face and laughing at me. I just have no respect for Oscar. You know, if you read up about him on Wikipedia, he's you know, he caught a charge on a 14-year-old little girl molesting her in Cabo San Lucas. You know, that is, he deserved it. I mean, if he did that, he deserved to be in jail for the rest of his life. You know, he's always getting a free pass, multiple DUI offender, multiple, you know, in and out of rehab. I mean, that guy needs some serious consequences on him. That's all I can say. I got nothing good to say about Oscar. I mean, I wish I did, but he's down. Yeah, he's a bad person. For me, what he did to me, that's bad. So, anyways.
You ain't doing that, but actually helping the brand. Real life, you're really
you know, it's like, I don't know, but, you know, Oscar's, I don't know, it's like Canelo's trainer or something, they were asking me to cut my hair and shit. It's like, they're not respectful either. Like, I just stay away from them. Like, I go to Top Rank, PBC, you know, I mean, Canelo's a good fighter, that's all I have to say about him, you know. You know, we waved at each other, peace signs from here, from distances, but never shook my hand, never greeted me, so can't really say anything about the guy, but you know, maybe he's like, I mean, I'm older than him, so you can't say that I look like someone younger than me, so maybe that's it. I mean, it could be when we're side by side, I was an inch taller than him, so maybe that inch makes a big difference. I have no idea, but I just do mean have fun. That's all I can say, you know.
So you're going to keep on taking the steroids. You're going to keep on taking the steroids for Triple G. You're not laying off. WBC giving you a pass.
Oh, man. I don't know what's going on with Like, I wouldn't gamble on it. Yeah. There's so much that could happen. Just, like, don't gamble on that fight. I mean, it's a big fight, so of course you want to gamble, but, you know, it's just so close. You're going to lose your money, or you could win your money. I mean, it's just watch the fight, enjoy it. It smells like weed so bad in here.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Everyone, this is
young, people
this,
are young, and
this is,
you got
this
young
is,
Latinos, you got the young, this, you know, boxing is transforming because of YouTube and Instagram, it's transitioning to a young person's sport. You know how you always, well, when I was young, I watched with my uncles, they still do, but not then. Boxing is getting a lot younger, too.
Yeah.
And it's always more contemporary, you know? And marijuana is legal there, too.
I know.
It's a high propensity to smoke, you know?
Smells great. This whole place is hot box. If you, like, everyone in here smells the weed, and they're enjoying it right now. That's all I can say about the Staples Center right now.
Last words?
Follow me on Instagram. Real Americanello. All one word. Real Americanello. I'll announce my next fight when I know.
Appreciate it.
Yeah.